Now they will be having a three options. While it publishes into your local system, wherein you can just open the file and provide your detailed version and you can see that. Second thing is you can actually publish the video which you kept it already in YouTube. So there will be an option where you can just directly export the video you have created or developed in YouTube.
Okay.
Third thing is it will ask where exactly the file which you have created has to be saved in your local system. Because Captivate, while you just install itself, it will be having its own section under documents saying for Adobe projects. Okay, so okay. This is where exactly you will be have to save the projects, and while opening also you will be having an option to open from the files or from the Captivate. Okay, any doubts here?
No, understood.
Okay, I'll just move forward.
Yeah.
So I was just telling about what exactly you can do in an Adobe Captivate. So as I told, e-learnings. So it depends like how many types of e-learnings you want to use it. You can use any number of, because the templates are free. It is all inbuilt. In 2019 versions, we have been introduced for assets. So in these assets itself, we will be able to see n number of templates, which is already been created as a project, wherein all you have to do is just go edit each and every whatever the things you wanted to do it. You can just edit only those, like in a text or maybe a picture or maybe an audio, so on.
Okay.
So interactive sessions. So that is again, we will be using in this demo purpose exactly. So you can just click anywhere and it will take you to the next slide. While demoing, you will be able to where they'll use a pointers for any presentations.
Yes.
So likewise, if you want to show live-like demos, you will have to use this interactive demos more often in order to make feel audience that you are using a live-like environment.
Okay.
Okay, that you can do it here. And also there are captions, call-outs, typical areas you can actually import your own audio also.
Okay.
If you have any audios, it has to be a noiseless, as you can understand, it has to be working on what your slide is for. So you will have to make sure it is noiseless in a background. Then you can create record an audio. Then you can import that into the Captivate projects.
Okay.
Then also there is another version where you can actually import any of the audios externally, which has already been created.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'll just move further. Now, what exactly this is a project while you publish it, as I was telling, right? Small web format. So this is an initial inbuilt format in which Captivate will be using for publishing. Any of the browsers will be supporting this. All you have to do is make sure there is no Flash player.
Okay.
Then HTML5, this is the latest update wherein only coding purpose, like it will be in a HTML format. If you want to publish this, you can do that. Okay. This usually what happens is, let me just give you an example, professionally, from one team to another team, they will be not able to publish it like how we do it. There will be an intermediate session for UAT. Hope you know. Okay. Right, it is a test environment.
Okay.
For them, we will have to provide through HTML5 itself.
Okay.
So they will make sure it will go live where others can make use of whatever the publishing video is.
Okay.
Okay. Now, this can be used by Android, mobiles, and Windows, all the versions, OS. Then there is MacBook also, you can download it. Then iPad, any other versions, it has to be with those particular formats, you can download it.
Okay.
So there are two types of download. One is for a free trial, one is for a licensed version. So you'll have to make sure I'll show you how do we do that in near future, wherein from the next session, you will have to start your practice in your downloaded version itself.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'll just move forward. So basically, this is how we started. What I'll do is I'll directly open the Captivate itself for you to better understand. Okay?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay, now you can see?
Yes.
Okay, great. So this is how you, the look and feel of Adobe Captivate. This is the latest version, which I have a trial version, which has been downloaded.
Okay.
And you can see the recent files. I have already created one and saved. In my previous session, I was just showing the practice session. So it is already here. If I want to open that, I will select and click on to open.
Yes.
There is a new tab which will actually have a plenty options. Now, let me just come back to you with the responsive project. Now, what exactly is responsive project? Now, you have been seeing the presentation from PowerPoint, right?
Yes.
That exact version will be shown here. Responsive project will be displayed in your desktop, in your mobile, and also in your iPad.
Yes.
Okay. So that is about responsive project. Now, while you come for virtual project, we will take this in a later version. What it does is it will actually take you to an image or video versions of 360 image. Hope you're aware of that, right?
Yes. Yes.
So while you just turn your laptop or move your mouse accordingly, it will start rotating.
Yes.
So such type of projects can be delivered here under virtual reality project. Now, while you're coming for blank project, it will just open a very blank slide and keeps open for the project to do so.
Okay.
Now, you're here for the software simulation. What exactly it means? We can actually record whatever you wanted. While you record the entire session, like, you know, I'm just clicking here and creating this, I can create this video. I'll show you now.
Okay.
For that purpose, we will use a software simulation. And simulation acts for one click, it will create a slide.
Okay.
Like that, you will have a slide version where you can start editing after coming back to Captivate.
Okay.
Okay. Now, please tell me if I'm fast, okay?
Yes.
Okay. Now, video demo is something where you create a video, okay, by your recording audios and all of those importing audios, call outs, and storyboards, everything which has to be kept ready, that particular video demo will be here.
Yes.
Then from PowerPoint, if you have an existing PowerPoint already, and you can actually import that PowerPoint and make it convert for Captivate files.
Okay.
So one more thing is Captivate file saves in CPTX format.
CPTX. Okay.
Yes. Other person who will be having or downloaded Captivate only open those files.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, they only can open those files. If not, you'll have to convert your video to MP4 or any other files that supports for them to open it.
Okay.
Even your interactive demos, you can preview it, but while publishing, you will have to save in MP4 files.
Okay.
So for anything other than CPTX, which has to be for any other people in order to open the files. So anyone who has already installed Captivate in their system, they can open any CPTX files.
Okay.
Done?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let me just open the blank project for you. There are resources also, like you can start utilizing your themed project already. Okay. Here, there are plenty of them. You can see that.
Yes.
You can select from here and start as well. Okay. So in future, if you are ready, then you can select one of these themes and start your project.
Yes.
Okay, am I clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, so let me just go back. So I will show you the sample project as well. I will send you a file, or I can show you in the later session.
Okay.
Now, while I just showed you how do we open the file, like in initially itself, the project which has already been showing, right? It will be there in our recent files. You just select that and open it.
Yes.
And we will have the similar method, like we will go to the file and we have an option for open. Then we select or browse wherever the file has been saved. We will open.
Okay.
Then there is another option. You can just directly go to the file wherever you have saved and you can double click and it will open in your calculator.
Yes.
Okay. So there are different methods, but it will all do the same thing.
Okay.
Now the sample project, I'm not sure it will open. Okay. It's here. Now it's better. I'll just show you directly in Captivate itself. Let me just go to a new and blank project. I will create.
There is a canvas button.
Sorry, canvas. This is a screen resolution it is asking for.
Okay.
So how much your desktop or iPhone or iPad or mobile phone, whatever it is, it will ask you that.
Okay.
It's a screen resolution basically.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Now, here we are in a blank project, Sriraj. Now, we will have two options, whether to edit in the same slide or you can create your own.
Okay.
Okay. Now, let me just do something I will just click here. So, this has opened me a section where I can actually make use of. One second. The properties which you can see here, the right hand side, just click that. Now, this section which I just selected, right?
Yes.
That particular section properties has been visible here in my properties. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, under style, I can see I have used a basic, section. It's a basic text. Now, while just going scroll down here, you can see there is a stroke style.
Yes.
There is a stroke style visible in different colors as well. Then going further down, I have a font size.
Yeah.
The font I have used here is Arial. Now, let me just change it. You saw that? It changed.
Yes.
Then there is a regular italic bold. You can see that, right?
And yes.
You cannot use a keyboard for this. Okay.
Yeah.
You cannot use a keyboard unless it has been selected, or else it is easy for you to select here under properties.
Okay.
Fine.
Yeah.
Okay. I will use a bold section. Now, while I'm using bold, let me just decrease my font size to somewhere like that. Okay. Yeah. Now, you can also use a bulletins. You can see the property here. We do have different form of bulletins.
Yes.
Okay. Numbers or alphabets or Roman numbers, dots, arrows, anything.
Yes.
Now, further to which you can also use, which is available in the Word format also, to change your, word or your sentence to the left, to the right, to the center, or make
justify. Yeah.
Justify. Okay. Then there is an middle or align also. You can just make it useful as you want. So why I'm telling you these are the basic things which will be very useful for you in order to just, when you get used to write, it will be very easy for you to, just go to the properties and keep editing it without doubt.
Yes.
Right. Then these are the things where you can actually in a bit of space wise, you can edit this. Just one space it will take. See. Okay.
Okay.
So if you click twice, it will take double space.
Okay.
So it will just take the space wise things here. Okay.
Okay.
Now, let me add one more line. Something like that. Then you can see, I will select these two. Okay. And there is a space. There is a spacing number. You can see that?
Yeah.
I will change that to You can keep seeing that. You can see here, it has taken space. Okay, you can change that also. Now, this color is blue. I can change the color with any number of colors. We do have various numbers and various forms. And there are few things wherein you can actually control over margins. Like, you know, usually what happens is in content development, we'll be very keen in order to make sure the margins are perfect in order to start your content, right? For that, we will use these margins. You can see that?
Yes.
Yeah, it will be very, very helpful for you. In order to, for the, especially, you know, content, like, you know, the text formats, which you use in a slide, if you could use the margins, it would be very helpful.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let me just click this breadcrumb here. It will be shadow and reflections, like this particular, which I selected the text field, right? There is none. If I could select this, it will take another field. Usually what happens, I'll have to select that. You can see that that section is taking its own.
Yes.
Something like that. Okay. So basically, it is like every purpose, whichever you want, you can just start editing. Even a small detail can be edited.
Okay.
Okay. Now, there is a slide here. You can see.
Yes.
You can just click that and you will have n number of types of slides you can utilize.
Yes.
Okay. Usually what happens in PPT also, if you select the slide, it will give you the same slide which you have already in the theme.
Yes.
But here, it will ask you what type of slide you want. Here you can see all of these are the different type of slides which are available. You can actually insert it with a second slide.
Yes.
Now, let me just come back again, take a step back in order to explain you about the ribbons. Now, under file, you will see all of these options where you can start your new project with all of these options. As I was just telling you about the initial screen, right? Where you can take a blank project, responsive project, etc. All of these are visible over here also.
Yes.
So you can choose any. It depends on the shortcut while you use over the keyboard. Or else you come here and select it. Okay.
Okay.
Then record new is where you will get your simulation demo. Like I said, how you record everything, that will be starting here. There is a device demo and also video demo option. You can start your simulation only here.
Okay.
If you want to open any file which you have already created and saved, you will have this option to open.
Okay.
Anything recent will be already in here, this file, see, which I've already got, the recent one is practice project, which is showing here.
Yes.
Okay. So that will be very easy. I always use this open recent for to open the previous one where I can start my editing.
Yes.
Close all, save everything, you might know.
Yes.
There is an important export where you can actually import your audio files, images, videos, any of your slides if you want, any of your hyperlink where you have to create for any PPTs, everything is available here.
Yes.
So you can choose accordingly and make sure certain format files only will be supportive and you can actually convert it. Nowadays, the latest OS will act as if, you know, you can take any of the files and convert it as you want. So you can just save it accordingly. You can start importing it. It will not stop you from doing that.
Okay.
Then you can also export it. As I was telling you about the flash, right? It is it is a reason why I said you'll have to stop it unless it will not be able to publish it in any of the browsers.
Okay.
Now, this is a publishing shortcut. You can use it. I was telling you about three different forms of publishing, right? So this is where it will start using the publish to YouTube and for settings.
Okay.
Then we have print. Actually, what happens is In my recent experience, what happened is any of those files which I have already saved, few people are not able to open it for many reasons.
Okay.
Maybe their OS is not updated or whatever the reasons, I'm not sure, but they were not able to open it. Hence, what they were asking is send a PDF format.
Yes.
Here in Captivate, how much it is restricted is, as I told you, the file has to be CPTX, the file has to be converted to MP4 unless you, the others will be not able to. So all of those reasons, there is no PDF format wherein exactly you will get the PDF file here.
Okay.
So I have used print. It will actually ask you what all the pages, how many slides, and what all the contents, and how the page should be, everything it will ask.
Yes.
You have to just select all of those and you publish it. While publishing, it will take Word format.
Okay.
You can edit whatever you want in your Word format. It will be very different version of Captivate while you publish in a Word format. So you will have to edit it. After editing, you can convert that file to PDF and you can share.
Okay.
Okay, that is one version. Please tell me if I'm fast, I can go slow.
No, I have available Adobe products, so I can understand easily. No problem.
Okay, that's really great.
Yeah.
Okay, next, moving on to edit. Edit, we have a few options only. It depends on how many projects you have already used or the properties you have been selected.
Okay.
Then we can go for zoom view, zooming in or zooming out, all of those. However you want the screen to be displayed, you can go to view.
Okay.
Now we have insert option. Here is where you will be inserting all of those audio files, video files, or your recorded version, or your voice, anything. It can be imported here.
Okay.
Then modification to do any of, like, you know, if I just put an image here in this slide, it will be on the text file. So yes. I can make that to go back. I can do that over arrange or
arrange align. Yeah.
Sorry. So all of this, you can use it accordingly. Then we have the project here. Project wise, we will be using however we want. It will show what are the advanced. I will not use basically all of this. I'll use the remedy of ribbon, which has been provided. It'll be easier for me to process further.
Okay.
Then we have quiz. As I was just telling you about the quiz, right? Which you can create a quiz that will be done over here. Then I was telling you about audio. You can import or record. You have that option here.
Yeah.
Then the speech management is separate. While you can actually record or allow the speech of management inbuilt here. You can just type something, select the voice, and that particular slide will have that. What do you say? Speech management. Like it will talk whatever the slide says.
Okay.
Okay. Next, there is a video. You know that you can insert a video. Then themes. We have different types of themes, which I'll be showing it to you in near future. Then this is about any of the Windows file which you are comfort with. We can make those particular things like whatever we are comfort with.
Okay.
Help is an inbuilt feature for Adobe. Even there is a community where you can just drop a note and they will get back to you for any help.
Okay.
Now, as you can also see, we do have these ribbons. Now I'll just come back to these.
Yes.
Now, as I was just telling you about slides, you got to know that.
Yeah.
We have themes here. Under themes, we will select different types. Since I have already used an empty project, it is showing me only these. If you want more, you can also browse. It is also like it will allow you to browse from any of the browser. You can inbuilt it. You can save it in your system and you can import it.
Okay.
And those particular theme properties will be shown also. Then. Text. This is also very normal. We have three types here. One is a normal text caption where you can just insert it as in provided it will actually show you. Yeah. This is a basic thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Then we do have entry box, like, you know, headlines and all, it will show you like that. Yeah. A box with a button.
Okay.
Okay. It is easy for you to, you know, you can avoid separate session, I mean, separate in order to import or insert a button.
Yes.
So this is the best option.
Yes.
The third is according to the animation, it will come. And you can select that particular action like this.
Okay.
Okay. You can change it here itself. And what all the animated versions you want, everything, you just change it here once for all. And you can see here, right?
Yeah.
So this is an animation it is asking for. You can change that.
Okay.
Oh no, this one has only one. If you can change, you can do that.